I don't want to ramble.
You gotta
let me rambling. Know if I'm not answering a question.
Though. I will, don't worry.
I first discovered my talent in elementary school, about like fifth or sixth grade. Me and my sister had written a children's book, art poems and stories of the heart. And we had collaborated on the poems, and I did all the illustrations and the painting. The cover of the book was designed by me, and it was one of the paintings I did. And after we had published the book and everything, and I was like, wow, it seems like I really have a knack for painting and art and creativity. My culture has a lot to do with where I get most of my inspiration from, whether it be the music. I'm surrounded by it every day, being that I'm first generation in this country being America. But I'm surrounded by it every day, from my parents speaking our language, mixing it with English, or just family members, or celebrating as even African music. So every part of my life, my culture is influenced by it. And through my culture, I use everything that I've been inspired by in my work, and I choose to focus on social issues and issues of identity and who am I in this country and what do I represent? Am I African-American? Am I Nigerian-American? Am I just American? So all of those things inspired me, and just trying to find that connection between my family in Nigeria that I did grow up with and my family here. That makes sense.
Makes good sense.
How do I get over my artist block, you could call it? Whenever my creativity is just stifled, then I can't really think about creating something new, or what should my next painting be, or my next piece. Often I go to the library a lot, so I will get books either on female artists. I will get books on, say I want to do a piece on African patterns and women, or women in fashion. And head wraps. So I'll go to the library and get books on fashion. I'll get books on East African style versus West African style. Styles from New York, Harlem Renaissance period. Things that inspire me and things that I find interesting and help me to get over that writer's block. So books, music, any form of art helps me to get over. Toyin Adetola, another one of my most recent artists is Carmen Olivia, and a lot of my older influences are artists like Frida Kahlo, Jacob Lawrence, a lot of them. So I draw influences from older artists and newer artists. What I learned from newer artists are their form of being able to use inspiration from what's been done already, but make it more contemporary and modern. And then older artists, I feel like you won't understand or have a full grasp of what you're doing if you don't think or read about or see or do your research on what artists before you did and what they drew inspiration from, and combining those two things together. I don't know what it is about it, but live music just inspires me. And being able to play an instrument and just create from that definitely inspires me. And even for me to just create, even for my thoughts to flow onto canvas and I can actually produce, I have to listen to music. If the room is silent, I can't really I tend to get caught up in my own thoughts. So it's like the music, while I'm listening to it, I can focus on what I'm doing. So I think other than that, music is really a huge part of what I do.
Awesome.
This piece is actually my most recent piece, and I entitled this piece One Drop, and there's a whole story behind it and why I chose to do this piece. So right now this is my favorite piece.
Okay, so what's the story behind why you chose to do it?
I knew you were going to ask that question, but the whole story behind this was, it's actually a portrait of a model. Again, it's a woman. Her name is Anaya Smiley, for those of you who follow the whole model industry. But again, this deals with issues of identity and gender issues. And I chose for it to be a woman, and I didn't want her to look, I wanted her to look perfect. Because that's another thing I do research on, like what do we see, what beauty is, what we see as being beautiful. We don't all see beauty as being the same thing, but we all gravitate towards perfection. And I choose to make her look as perfect as possible. And I called her One Drop because you can't really tell where is she from, you know, what is she mixed with. And that one drop is that 1% of Black that she is. So is she African American? Is she the other race I can't think of right now, but, and then I chose to incorporate African fabric into this piece, going back to Black women in general and how we sometimes box ourselves up, like, what does her hair look like? You know, we get too caught up in our hair, and I love the fact that I put away, all you can focus on is their face, so you can't tell if her hair is natural, she's rocking the weed, if it's straight, if it's curly, and then the different patterns and textures, I chose to use actual fabric because I wanted it to tie back to where is she from, what, you know, we all, as much as some of us don't like it, most of us can tie our lineage back to someplace in Africa. So I chose to incorporate that in my piece, and I like the fact that it's different colors and different patterns, and that ties back to everything being all mixed up and the confusion of it all. What I love most about art is being able to build a canvas from scratch and start from canvas and wood and the finished product would be a full painting, and it's like, how do you start from nothing, a blank slate? And I feel like a lot of that can be translated to life. And starting from nothing and being able to build something that other people can appreciate, I think that would be good. My advice would be to just follow your dream and your passion. I know it sounds cliche, but I'm not gonna lie, it's not easy at all. But I feel like if you're good at what you do and you have a good support system, there's no reason why you can't be successful at what you do. You have to be, for one, very hardworking. You have to develop a backbone. And at the same time, you have to surround yourself by people who support you. If you are not surrounded by people, the world in itself, a lot of people are going to discourage you. Not surrounded by family and friends who don't see the vision in what you do, how can you continue to stay encouraged and see, you know, and live out your life's passion? I know I've been blessed to have a family who supports me, and plenty of times being, you know, first generation Nigerian in this country and my family, especially being the firstborn, it's almost seen as a taboo, like, what? You're going to be an artist? So what are you going to do, sit and paint all day? And it's just like, really, like, there's so many things that we take for granted, and art is in every part of our lives. For you to appreciate the detail in your handbag or your shoes, an artist created that. But yet we take that for granted and see it as, I need to be a nurse, so I need to be an engineer or doctor to be successful. But I feel like if you have your family that's supporting you, there's no reason you can't be successful. If someone was interested or you're interested in my work, for one, where we're at right now is Brentwood Art Exchange, and I have some of my pieces here, prints for sale, and other artists' work too as well. Also, I'm online at www.chichisart.com. Twitter, Facebook, all forms of social media. Instagram is at art underscore is Adama, A-D-A-N-M-A. And Facebook fan page is chichisart.com. And all those forms, my website is the best way to reach me.